So, business performance management, if we generally talk about in the sense how the business performance, what is meant by performance? How we are able to utilize the resources of a business and how we can optimally make the organization into profitable and how we can accomplish our goals. That is what we call it as the main objective of an organization or business or firm. So, what are the different tools, techniques we use to measure the organization performance? So, whether our organization is doing good, whether our organization is going to be failed, means it is under downgrade or upgrade. So, how could you know performance? We are daily, we are analyzing ourselves, how we are improving. That is what the main objective of this unit, that is business performance management. So it can be generally defined as the sum total of tools, the sum total of, I already wrote, sum total of tools, techniques, matrices used to measure the organizational performance. It's also considered as a with another name, that is what we call it as corporate performance management. So we have additionally, along with the business, we say it is corporate performance management, or sometimes we can also call as enterprise performance management. These are the different names we can call with business performance management or corporate performance management or enterprise performance management. So there is some more points we can talk about later in words. So just I'm introducing, there is something like a strategic gap. The strategic gap, in the sense, there is a difference. There is a gap in the sense there is something which is lagging in. So you are, for example sake, your understanding of the subject available in notes and your understanding about the subject, if you are unable to understand, means there is a gap. Whatever you are saying, the other person unable to understand, it is what we generally call it as communication gap. So the gap is there is something lagging where we cannot meet our expectations. That's what we generally call it as strategic gap. What are the organization strategies and what are the actual strategies? If there is a difference, we consider that one as a strategic gap. So we are talking about these things in upcoming lectures of the same unit, that is business performance management. Let's talk about this. Let's talk about just a moment. So let's talk about this. So what is meant by BPM? That is business performance management. How we define it? What is the definition we call it as? Or how we define it? And what are the different components available? In business performance management, the main objective, it is defined as a different business tools. So just now we spoke about it. There are so many different business tools. And what are, along with that, we talk about different techniques. Along with that, what are the different methodologies we use? Along with that, we also use metrics, which are employed by organization to measure. So what is the main objective? To measure. What we measure and manage the performance, measure and manage the performance of business. Don't forget the primary objective of this. It's what we call it as performance. So we are going to employ different business tools, techniques, methodologies, and matrices to measure and manage. It's not only for measuring, to even manage the performance of business or an enterprise. So there are so many different application, different definitions exist. So it reflects the same. Performance management involves thinking through various facts of performance, identifying critical dimensions performance, planning, reviewing, developing and enhancing performance. So these are all things exist. So but the final what the it is going to reflect is the same. What are the different tools and techniques? According to, there is one more definition you need to understand. According to Reward Management Associates, these are what it's a standard organization association exists. The performance management may be defined as managerial process. Just let me write down. It's a managerial process which consists of planning, performance, review, through observation and feedback. And when we talk about these are the, this is what the another definition we find. And what do you find the features? How we can identify the BPM? What are the different features of business performance management? There are the, some key features exist. It is also known by, as we know, it is a corporate performance management or enterprise performance management. And sometimes we can also call it as strategic performance management. That the main objective of the BPM is mostly it is a wide range of tools and techniques. So we are not deviating from the main objectives. Those are tools and techniques, methodologies and metrics, which used to assess the actual performance of the organization, business organization. The next, what are the components? What are the different components of BPM? So as we come across, the key component of the BPM is closely linked to management and analytical process. So there is a strong relationship that exists between the management and analytical process. This is what the main component. So what the main understanding of what is meant by analytical process? The promise is, the processes are fully integrated with the technology. The prime focus, the area, it is what we call it as a closed loop management process, which addresses and assesses the financial and operational activities of the organization. Financial, the main focus is on financial and operational activities. If you talk about these two activities, they considered as the primary activities, because without operations the organization cannot survive, and even it reflects to the event finance. So continuation of the processes, that is operational activities, and finance, which supports those operational activities, it's nothing but the financial operations. So these managing and analytical process, the components of BPM, the key component, it's closely related with the linked with the management and analytical process because of these reasons. And then next, BPM components includes all business tools, techniques, where we are trying to define, formulate, measure the strategic goals of the organization. Again, we are not deviating. Again, we are talking about those points like the tools, techniques, methodology is used to formulate. This is what the main technique. We used to formulate And even we try to measure the strategic goals of the organization. Measure the strategic goals of the organization. The next one, we talk about the other important component, the tools and techniques of financial and operational planning. The metrics employed for measuring the key performance indications and so on and so forth. So, main focus on finance and operational activities, and along with that operational activities, we also concentrate on financial and operational strategies which applies to define tools and formulate the measures. The next one, we talk about the difference, basic difference between BPM and business intelligence. You could know that, sir, BPM is nothing but business performance management, and BI is business intelligence. We are discussing third unit, but in third unit we have a BPM at of business intelligence only. Then how far they are related? So they have taken into one point to consider on what basis we separate the business performance management with business intelligence. Let us discuss about that. When we are trying to define the BPM, there are business tools we'll come across. Business different tools, different techniques, different methodologies or methods and matrices are employed. Whereas in case of business intelligence, it's art and science of analyzing. It's nothing but art and science which it tries to analyze any data or information with specific business objective, with specific business objective. This is what we call it as business intelligence. It's an art and science of analysis. Any data or any information with specific business objective. Whereas in case of BPM, they are just tools and techniques, methods for to manage the business performance. Then whereas when we talk about the scope of the business, scope is a wide range. Because the impact of business performance management can be considered outgrowth of BI. It's considered as outgrowth of business intelligence. Yeah, just